Camp Catawba. It was a place of theater and of song, of outdoor adventures and innermost thoughts. For 26 summers, young boys from across the country came together at Camp Catawba for an experience that would touch their hearts forever. Camp Catawba was the creation of Dr. Vera Lockman, a teacher and a poet, who founded the camp in 1944 and directed it until 1970. Vera grew up a member of a Jewish family in Berlin, Germany, and narrowly escaped with her life during the Nazi Holocaust. A new citizen of the United States, Vera discovered Blowing Rock, North Carolina in 1944. There she found land for sale, and on it the dilapidated remnants of an old farm that would become her Camp Catawba. Vera ran Camp Catawba not for financial gain, but for the 30 boys who arrived every summer in the back of the camp's truck. The campers, aged 5 to 12, came mostly from northern cities. They slept in a converted chicken house, which they called a citadel, and awakened to trumpet music and morning exercises. Vera then held assembly on the front lawn of the main house, the building which was the heart of Camp Catawba. The campers ate in its dining rooms. They played Bach and attended Sunday services in its front room. Here they performed plays by Shakespeare and Aristophanes. Uphill from the main house was their ball field, downhill their swimming pond. They went horseback riding and hiking at nearby Cone Estate. Alongside Vera worked the camp's music director, Tui St. George Tucker. Tui conducted the camp choir and orchestra. Her program at Catawba led a number of campers to become professional musicians. At the age of 65, Vera Lockman chose not to reopen the camp for the 1971 season. Over 400 campers visited her Camp Catawba during the summers it was in operation. Vera passed away in 1985, leaving the camp to the Blue Ridge Parkway.
We should like to have the boys learn to live in a group, respecting other individuals, to be happy without trampling on anybody else's rights, to enjoy the beautiful instead of the cute, to have the courage both physically and morally, and the fun of their age, instead of imitating the boring amusements of helpless grown-ups.